In this video, we'll explore the long-run cost function and get an introduction to the long-run average cost curve. We'll have a good understanding by the time the video is over, and if you have any questions throughout it, leave a comment below. Let's go back to the beginning of our discussion on production. We should be able to recall our inputs, including machinery, labor, and the factory. In our short-run discussion, we saw only the quantity of labor was variable. In the long run, the quantity of all factors of production is variable. Specifically, the difference between the short run and long run is the ability to vary capital. The long run cost function is therefore based on the assumption that all factors of production are variable. The graph of the long run average cost curve is U-shaped. Our axes are for costs and output. And our long run average cost curve is also U-shaped like the short run average cost curve, but there is a different explanation as to why this is the case. You'll remember in our short run diagram that we held capital constant. In the case of the long run curve, it's composed of all the short runs. Let me explain what I mean. Imagine a business that has just started. The first factory they build is their constant capital. The level of labor is variable for this firm, and it has its own short-run average cost curve at this level of capital. Then the firm decides to expand. Now that it is increasing its capital as well, we now enter a separate short-run phase of the firm. We consider their short-run average cost curve when they operate two factories. Remember, the short-run holds capital constant. As a firm expands, each of these sections divided by the dotted red lines represents a different short-run period. Let's see how this looks when we draw it out. For each individual short run, I've plotted the corresponding short run average cost curves. One trend you may have noticed is the drop in average costs as the firm expands. The short run cost curves are tangential to the long run average cost curve. The long run average cost curve is said to envelope the various short run average cost curves. The lowest point of SRAC curve 3 that is tangential to our LRAC curve represents our minimum efficient scale, because it is the point at which costs are minimized and no further cost advantages are generated from growth. I'll look at this idea in economies of scale further in the next video. For now, make sure you can distinguish between short-run and long-run cost curves, and also understand how the long run is composed of many short runs. By now, you should have developed a better understanding of the long-run cost function and the shape of the long-run average cost curve. If you have any questions or comments, you can email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com or leave them below. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.